Google. Ajá.
Hey, what is going on YouTube? Thanks for tuning in to another video. And today I wanted to show you a cheap way of getting a fast charger for your new iPhone 8, 8 Plus, and also iPhone 10. Now, I'm sure any fast charging capable phone could be doing the same, but the reason I'm doing this for the iPhones that I just mentioned is because I have an iPhone 10. And I know the capabilities are also with the iPhone 8 as well. So with that, I wanted to show you a cheap way of getting into the fast charger for your new iPhone. So the reason I have so many of them is because I'm gonna tell you how I got these. I got them through eBay, and if you look at the actual device itself, this is a wall charger here. And it runs for about $20. What you see there in front of you cost me a total of almost $25. Now, when you look at just one item itself, let's take a look at just this wall charger. I only bought one wall charger. And the reason I bought just one is because I have another one in the iMac, my iMac charger. But see, right here, it's $20 just for one thing. Now, for whatever reason, the seller of this one was selling it for close to $7, like $6.80, I believe. And this was the only one that I can see at that price. So, and then when you look at these other ones, these are the same. They're three car chargers, as you can see. Now, I will have a video of testing out the car chargers, because as you can see in this one right here, look at the size of this small, powerful charger. This right here is a 27 watt fast charger. Now, if you have a 12 inch MacBook, this can charge a 12 inch MacBook. Look at this one right here. And if you see the difference here, this is a wall charger and this is a car charger. And they're both the same 27 watt chargers. But if you take a look at the other video that I posted or that I will be posting, it's going to show you the capabilities of this fast charger, and you're going to be surprised. But I bought those, I bought three of these at $6 even each, so $18, and then I bought this for $6.70, $6.80, close to that $25. So I have one in my car, two in my car, and then one in my wife's car. So definitely, now I'm going to say this is on the cheap, because if you buy this brand new, I believe Apple sells their cables, as you can see here, you know, at a ridiculous price. So you add that plus, you know, $20 if you go to Verizon and pick this up, it's going to cost you, you know, quite a bit of money just to get a, you know, fast charge capabilities. It's definitely worth it to charge, you know, to do a fast charge, but you know, when you're really tight on cash, this is what this video is for. So we're gonna go ahead and test that out just to show you. Alright, so changing the cameras here. I have here the iPhone 10, as you can see. It is currently at 70%, which should still fast charge. And I know the glare on the screen there. We'll go ahead and clear that out. So I went ahead and charged it. You can see it's being charged. For those of you who don't know, whenever you charge using fast charging a device on an iPhone, it tends to show the chart or make that charge indicator noise about 2 times. So I don't know why, but does that. So I'm gonna go ahead and zoom in here, and as you can see, it is at 9 volts at 1 amp, so that's roughly about 9 watts. Now the reason for this is because it's getting up there in charge, so it's at 70%, so it's still of course charging, but not at its full potential, especially when you're at like 10, 5%, 20%, 30%. So there you have it.
This is charging, fast charging an iPhone or any fast charging device on the cheap. Again, this thing cost me close to $7. The cable is probably gonna be what's gonna cost you the most. Again, now there is third party ones, but you gotta be careful with them because some of them only charge, you know, at 2 amps, which is normal charger like you would see here. You know, from Apple, this is a 2 or 2.1 amp charger, or 2.4 amp charger, because it can charge an iPad up to 2.3 amps, according to the USB reader. So, again, that's something that you can make your choice on, but I'll have links. I haven't bought one myself yet, but you know, obviously if you buy it from a reputable company like Amazon and it doesn't work, then you can of course return it, stating that it's not as advertised. So that's what I'm gonna go ahead and do, and I'm gonna make a video on that. But for right now, this is the cheapest way you can go, is go through eBay, look for this USB-C charger. And if you like need to get a cable and you feel comfortable with Apple's, they're about like $16-17 the original Apple cable. But if you want like a third party, you're probably gonna spend about $11 for it. So you know, you definitely save some cash. And that's where I wanted to spend for a cable like this was about $10. So I'm gonna test it out and we'll go from there. But if you have any questions, feel free to leave them on the comments down below. And I hope this video helps you out. I'll catch you in the next one.